You're listening to the audio production of Devotions for Christmas, a celebration to bring you joy and peace, published by Zondervan and read by Marni Penning. December 1st, focusing on Jesus. Let us keep our eyes on Jesus, the source and perfecter of our faith. Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 through 2, Holman Christian Standard Bible. Have you noticed that Christmas seems to show up in stores earlier each year? Many stores have had Christmas decorations on display since September, right next to the Halloween costumes and fall wreaths. Coffee shops were already selling gingerbread lattes when it was still 80 degrees outside. Why is there this insane rush from one holiday to the next? Did you know there is actually a term for this blending of holidays? It's called Hallowthanksmas. Now that's frightening. Can we all agree that our grandmothers would not have approved of Hallowthanksmas? If we were honest, we'd probably admit that we don't enjoy it all that much ourselves. It's just so easy to get carried away with activity this time of year, and we don't always know how to slow it all down. But there is a way to step off the crazy train and reclaim Christmas. What's the secret? Having a singular focus. We can choose to not rush the celebration of Christ's birth. This December, join me in focusing each day on Him, as Paul said, on the source and perfecter of our faith. Even though at this very moment the stores are enticing us to focus on decorations, gifts, and holiday treats, let's purposefully heed Paul's advice and keep our eyes on Jesus. We may have already gotten caught up in Hallowthanksmas, but that's okay. It's not too late to take back December. We can stop looking ahead to the next thing and instead fix our gaze on what is before us. How nice would it feel to take a deep breath and focus on the blessing of a baby born in a manger to save us from our sins? For the remainder of this holiday season, let us move forward in joy, giving Christ our full attention. You, Lord, are worthy of our focused attention. Help us to fix our gaze upon your goodness and to not be distracted by the next thing. Amen. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, on them had light shone. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there will be no end, on the throne of David and over his kingdom to establish it and uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 2. And verses 6 through 7. December 2nd, surprise packaging. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, and no beauty that we should desire him. Isaiah chapter 53, verse 2. Harriet has a real gift when it comes to gift wrapping. She's given concert tickets tucked inside empty cereal boxes and jewelry disguised in old coffee cans. No empty container is off limits. Harriet takes great joy in surprising people with offbeat packaging, and they never guess what's inside. What about you? Do you judge presents by the packaging? Have you ever been surprised by what was inside? The children of Israel were anticipating the coming of the Messiah, and they had a certain image in their minds. They were awaiting the arrival of a military leader who would show up on the scene with a lot of fanfare. They were expecting someone who would demand attention and respect by his very presence. Can you imagine their confusion when the Christ child made his humble entrance into the world? From the very beginning, Christmas has been about precious gifts in unexpected packaging. The Son of God entered our world clothed in the flesh of an infant. God's plan to redeem and restore his people began with a newborn's cry. It was the ultimate surprise gift. Scripture is full of God's choosing to wrap gifts in mysterious ways, from the heart of a king hidden inside of a shepherd boy, to the Messiah in a manger, to angels disguised as strangers. He is full of beautiful surprises. Let's not miss a single one of them. It's so easy to get caught up in appearances. We make snap judgments about people, about events in our lives, about the reasons why something seems to have happened. But when we do that, we can miss out on the best gifts. That grouchy neighbor could end up being a lifesaver. That loss of a job could be an opening to a new path. And if you're Harriet's friend, that Crisco can could hold something you just might like. Let's ask God to open our eyes to the beautiful surprises that are all around us. I am so thankful, Lord, that you came the way you did. Thank you for teaching us to see beyond the wrapping to the beautiful gift inside. Amen. December 3rd, Heavenly Peace. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests. Luke chapter 2, verse 14, New International Version. Let's face it, Christmas can be a stressful time. We get caught up in trying to create the perfect holiday for our families. We worry about family members not getting along or the mashed potatoes being too lumpy. Before we know it, we find ourselves longing for a little of the peace we hear about in Christmas carols. Can you relate? Has your holiday season become so full of pressure that you wonder if peace is even possible? When Christmas rolled around in 1914, World War I was in full swing. Though Pope Benedict XV suggested a temporary ceasefire in honor of the holiday, the warring countries refused to make it official. Peace did not seem to be anywhere in sight. When the holiday arrived, the soldiers themselves chose to lay down their weapons in honor of Christmas. It was the first reprieve in months. The sound of gunfire was replaced with the sound of singing. Enemies were reported to have exchanged gifts and played games. Though the war was far from over, the Christmas truce of 1914 brought a little peace in the midst of conflict. What conflict are you dealing with this Christmas? Is there family drama, a financial struggle, or a health concern? No matter the specific circumstance, Christ has promised his peace to you. Peace is always available to those of us who love him. Our holidays do not have to be marked by stress and conflict. We can quit holding on to old grudges. We can let go of envy, worry, and fear.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.